Hello and welcome. My name is Manisha Shivaramani and you're watching Flash On. Jhalkari Bai was a legendary woman warrior who played a crucial role in the Indian Rebellion of 1857 during the Battle of Jhansi in the Women's Army of Queen Lakshmi Bai of Jhansi. Born on November 22, 1830, she grew up to become a soldier, eventually becoming Lakshmi Bai's trusted advisor. While she is remembered for her courage and sacrifice, what is significantly reminiscenced about her is that she disguised herself as the queen and fought to let the queen escape safely out of the fort. Jhalkari Bai may have never met Rani Lakshmi Bai had it not been for her betrothal to Puran Singh, a soldier in the queen's army. Said to be a soldier of great caliber, his skills were quickly recognized by the generals in the court. And it was also around this time that the fateful meeting between Jhalkari Bai and the warrior queen would take place. During Gauri Puja, Jhalkari Bai went to the fort along with a number of women from the village. It was there that the legendary Jhansi Ki Rani spotted her, and she was taken aback by the uncanny resemblance she had with Jhalkari and inquired about her immediately. When the queen was briefed on Jhalkari's brave acts, she was quickly inducted into the women's wing of the army. Here, she was trained to shoot and ignite cannons as the army was preparing for a British invasion. The Battle of 1857 is the stuff of legends in India. It started with the mutiny of sepoys on May 10, 1857 in Meerut, and it quickly gave rise to a number of rebellions across North and Central India. Deemed the first war of independence, Jhansi played a crucial role in the rebellion, and Rani Lakshmi Bai was among the leaders who took on the British forces. It was in 1858 when Field Marshal Hugh Henry Rose attacked Jhansi to put an end to the mutiny once and for all. The brave queen took on the British forces from her fort with just an army of 4,000. She could have held on to the fort for longer, but she was betrayed by one of her own commanders, thus making defeat imminent. Counseled by her generals to escape immediately, Lakshmi Bai quietly slipped away from Jhansi on horseback. That's when Jhalkari sprung to action. Jhalkari's husband Puran was killed defending the fort, but instead of mourning her loss, she worked out a plan to deceive the British. She dressed up like Lakshmi Bai and took command of the Jhansi army. Without thinking twice about the kind of danger she was putting herself in, and walked right up to General Rose's camp. Upon reaching, she loudly yelled that she wanted a meeting with the general himself. This plan was both to keep the enemy forces at bay and also give the queen more time to evade capture and get out of harm's way. Rose and his men were exultant. Beside capturing Jhansi, the British thought they had caught the queen alive. When the general, thinking she was the queen, asked Jhalkari what should be done to her, she firmly said, "Hang me." Bundelkhand legend has it that her reply stunned the general, who said that if even 1% of Indian women were like Jhalkari, the British would have soon left India. It was only a day later, when a man named Dula Ju identified Jhalkari, that the British learned of the deception. There is a lot of confusion regarding her death. Some say that she died immediately after this incident, and some say she was set free and lived a long life afterward and passed away only in 1819. Her life as a warrior continues to be sung in various Bundeli folklore even today. Her bravery along with her identity as a Dalit has helped to create a sense of pride and culture unity in Dalits across North India. A Dalit woman with no kingdom or palace, a woman neither a queen nor a daughter of any feudal lord, also not the wife of any jagirdar, is the one who fought selflessly and fearlessly. Her sacrifice far surpasses anyone else's. Well, that's all for Flash On today. If you like the video, do share and subscribe to My Nation. Thank you so much for watching.